Red Hat Summit Day 2, the focus shifted to foundational platforms.
And we saw some amazing new features in action. So exciting.
Welcome back. I'm David Walker, and today is day 2 of Red Hat Summit 2025. Yesterday was all about the big AI vision, but today we're diving into open hybrid cloud. I'm joined today here with Isabella Gonzalez of the Red Hat Enterprise Linux product marketing team. Isabella, thank you for joining us.
It's so great to be here. Day 2 was packed, especially for us on the RHEL side, but really for anyone who's looking to make innovation happen.
And speaking of making innovation happen, Lee Day, Chief Marketing Officer, kicked things off by celebrating some truly innovative customers with Red Hat Innovation Awards.
It's always so inspiring to see how companies are using Red Hat technologies to make a real difference. Lee highlighted these awards, now in their 19th year, to recognize customers showcasing exceptional use of technology to impact people's lives.
Following that, Ashesh Badani, Chief Product Officer, like he mentioned yesterday, really talked about the deeper dive into RHEL 10, and he called it the biggest leap forward in Linux history in over a decade. I mean, talk a little bit about your perspective and what you got from the demos.
It was fantastic to see RHEL 10 in action. For me, image mode is a real game changer. Ashesh said, just like a smartphone, you now have a simple upgrade. They even showed a single command rollback. It just takes so much of the complexity out of managing system drift.
So that ease of use is definitely a consistent theme. But what about, you know, RHEL Lightspeed?
Seeing the AI-powered command line assistant analyze logs and suggest fixes was just wow.
It's like having RHEL experts built in.
Exactly. And Mike McGrath joined Ashesh to emphasize the security enhancements. They're really future-proofing RHEL 10 for next-gen threats.
The spotlight then shifted to Ansible Automation Platform, the role in its AI-driven landscape.
Ansible is so crucial.
That improvement to Ansible Lightspeed with watsonx Code Assistant looked great, making it even easier to create automation. But what really stood out was Ansible's role in AI and policy. The demo showed how event-driven Ansible can observe, decide, and then act at scale. But now, the automated policy enforcement at runtime.
AI can make decisions, but Ansible ensures that they stick to the rules that humans define.
Mm-hmm. That governance is key. And there was also news about a deepened partnership with HashiCorp.
So many customers use Ansible with Terraform and Vault. Seeing them work even more tightly together for end-to-end automation is something that people are really excited about.
That's our recap for day 2 of Red Hat Summit. We'll see you next time.